this video here is to the mothers. You know, a lot of times it may seem like I'm bashing mothers, but I'm not. I'm not bashing every single mother. I'm just bashing the mothers who are using the system to use our kids against us fathers who are doing the right thing. And mothers, don't get me wrong. I understand what you're going through. I'm not a mother, no. But I've did enough research and I've spoken to enough mothers to understand and know that what you guys are going through, because I'm a father on the other side of the fence going through the BS. So I understand what you're going through. I feel your pain, but I'm asking you today. Sometimes you may have a baby daddy or a baby father, a husband, whatever you want to call him, that's not taking care of his child. And yes, it gets emotional, and the first thing you want to do is make him pay. And I understand that. Revenge sometimes may be the first thing that comes to mind. But revenge is always a form of reacting. But you see, mothers, I'm asking you to respond to the situation, not react. Because you see, when we react, most reactions are negative. But I'm asking you to respond to the situation, meaning that take the time to think about it. Is it about me getting revenge, or is it about me making sure that I have a child's father in my child's life? And yes, you will run into some fathers. No matter what you do, they're not going to step up to the plate. And I understand that. But please, even if you have to take a man to court to pay child support, that's fine. But do me a favor, mothers, please do not talk bad to the child about the father. Don't do that. Stop thinking that you can't do it alone. I know a lot of mothers are thinking, telling their kids, their sons, their daughters, oh, you don't need no father. Oh, I'm the mother. I'm all you need. And no, that's not right. Because you think you could do it alone. And I'm certainly sure a lot of you guys have been doing it alone. But look at the statistics of single parents, single mothers. More than half of the time, these kids end up in jail. They end up pregnant. You understand? They grow up thinking they don't need a father. And that's not a good thing. So yes, you may be getting the money from the court, but in the long run, is it worth the price your child have to pay? Stop listening to some of your friends that don't have kids, fathers in their lives doing what they're supposed to do. And they, you see, misery loves company. You understand? And they will put you through the same thing that they're going through because they're jealous of you, making you think that they are your friends, but they're not. A friend wouldn't ask you to let your children go without a father. So that's not being a friend. So please, mothers, I'm asking you. Yes, a man is supposed to take up his responsibility. I know you didn't have that child by yourself. I know it's emotional and I know it hurts. But at the same time, think about it. Is it worth the price my son or my daughter have to pay for not having a father in their life? You understand? So once again, let the man pay child support. I understand that. And you may get $200, $300, $400, $500, $600, $700, $800 a month. But where's that emotional connection to the father? That's what the kids need. They don't need a new pair of sneakers. They don't need a new pair of designer pants. They don't need that. A child could have regular clothes from a regular designer, but yet still, he or she could be more grounded because he has both parents in their lives. So we need to stop that fight, fathers against mothers, and thinking it's all about us. It's not about us. It's about our children. So we need to wake up, fathers and mothers. We need to wake up and understand that our kids are the ones paying the price. So mothers, this is my plea to you. Yes, he has to accept his responsibilities. But under any circumstances, you should not turn a child against his or her father. You understand? Regardless of what he has done to you, that's between you and the man. Please leave the children out of that equation because they don't need that stress. They have enough that they deal with outside the home. And when they come home, they need to, the home is supposed to be a safe haven. The home is supposed to be a place of love, teaching our kids how to love. So stop turning our kids against us. You understand? Yes, again, it may be a father who's not doing anything, who hasn't done anything. So what? Always leave that window of opportunity so that a man could come back into his child's life. You understand? And I'm not making excuses for those dudes. I'm not. I know they're deadbeat dads, and I don't condone that. But at the same time, you as a mother, it's your responsibility to not turn your child against his or her father. I know it's tough, and I know I'm asking a lot. It is a lot, really, because you guys really go through a lot. And I really just want you to know, there may be fathers who don't appreciate what you guys do, but me as a father, I appreciate you as a mother and the struggles you go through and what you do. And to me, every day is Mother's Day. Every single day is Mother's Day because you guys do it. I don't know how you do, but God knew what he was doing when he made you a woman because you guys are strong. I respect that. But you see, when it comes to the emotional aspect of being a woman, sometimes it has to be, sometimes you guys just have to curb that when it comes to the kids. You understand? I know sometimes you may look at your son or your daughter and he reminds you or she reminds you of the father. And right there, boom, you want to get at the daughter, you want to get at the child. Only because of that, the baby father is not taking care of the child. You know what? I know that you have a right to be mad. You have a right to be angry. You have a right to want to get back at him. But just let him pay. That's the way. Just let him pay the child support. And try to encourage him. And I know, you know what? I know you guys try to encourage the man and give him a lot of opportunities to be a father. And some of them don't care. But still, keep that faith. Don't give up. Leave that window of opportunity there for that child. Our kids will grow up differently, knowing that regardless of what happened, you know, daddy wasn't there. But I never once heard my mother talked bad about my father. The kids will end up respecting you more for that. So please, I'm asking you as a father. Again, I don't know what it is to be a mother, but I'm asking you as a father, please, try your best not to talk to your kids bad about your kid's father. All right? Because I'm just a dad trying to make sure that every single child has I'm just a dad that's trying to make sure that every single child has an active father in his or her life. And I will try my best. And I will never stop walking down the street and helping a single mother push a stroller, take that carriage, bring it down the subway station. I will never stop that because I'm passionate about that. Mothers, I understand your plea. I understand your cry. I understand the struggle you're going through. Trust me, I really do. And you got all my support in the world. You really, really do. But I'm just asking for this one favor. Yes, let that man pay his child support. But please, when it comes to the children, try your best not to talk bad about the father to the kids. Just leave that window of opportunity. Who knows, he may come around. He may not. But I promise you, your kids will grow up healthier kids. They'll have more respect. You understand? And that's what it's all about. And at the end of the day, it's all about the kids. It's not about we adults. We fighting. Keep the fighting away from the kids, man. They don't need to hear that. They don't deserve that. We need better. We as parents, we supposed to set the examples. So I'm just asking you for that favor. Please, do it for me. Do it for your child. All right? It will make a difference. I guarantee you that. And I will keep on my struggle. I will keep on the fight. And mothers, keep doing what you're doing. A lot of you guys do a great job. And I appreciate that. I really appreciate that. Thank you.